Hi, I am Alexandra Barker. In this data gem, I'll show you how to save your work on data.census.gov. Once you spend so much time selecting geographies, selecting topics, and finding that perfect data table, there is no need for you to do this work again when you need the same data. Let me show you how to get it done. So start by going to data.census.gov. What I'll show you now is a trick that I often use when I want to save a data table or the filters of my search for future use. This includes my geographies and variables. It's all based on using the URL from your browser, not only to save your work, but you can edit the URL just to access different data sets and data tables. Once you become familiar with these tricks, it's very easy to use them for a variety of shortcuts. I find it so helpful. For this example, I'll show you how to save your filters. Let's go to Advanced Search to select our geographies and topics. Let's click on Advanced Search so we can start selecting our geographies and topics. Let me select a geography. For this example, let's use states and now select a field. Let's say Alabama. I'll click in Georgia. A few more. Let's go with Mississippi. Let's add Louisiana. The geographies that you see right here in the basket where it says selected filters are saved in a URL link. Right here, these numbers represent your saved geographies. They go by FIPS codes. Now let's check how to save your geographies along with your variables. Let's go to topics and select a variable. Let me click on population and people, and then age and sex. As soon as you add your variable to your basket, it's now represented here in the URL, age and sex. By saving this URL as a bookmark or on a document, you'll be able to just copy and paste using a different browser window and access again your basket with the same filters. Now let's change your variable. Let's delete age and sex by clicking on the X. And let's go look for another variable. Let's go to race and ethnicity and race and ethnicity. As you can see, now it's added to your selected filters and it's also showing on your URL. Now let's check how this can bring you to a data table. Click on Search. And the tables you see now are a result of the filters for geography and the variable race and ethnicity. Let's go back to the beginning and work on a different example so we can see different ways we can work with this URL. So let's start by searching for a geography. I'll go with Bronx County, New York. And just to start this example, I'm going to click in one of the data profiles, in this case, the DP05, which is for the demographic and housing estimates of the American Community Survey. This is about Bronx County, but it can be about any geography or geographies and any type of data set you have. As you can see, right here is the URL. This link includes the source of your data, American Community Survey, the table, the data profile, this is the product type, the year, 1 year estimate, as well as the year for your estimate, 2018, and the exact table ID, DP05. Your geography is also right here. So once you save this, whether as a bookmark in your browser or in a document, like you can see right here, I do this very often. You can click on this URL and go back to the same table for the geography you selected. This becomes very helpful if you have selected so many geographies, several tracks, several cities and towns, you spend so much time looking at variables and finding the perfect table. This becomes really helpful. I usually put it in a document and I label, and I recommend you do the same. Because next year, let's say we're releasing the 2019 American Community Survey data, and you want to access that without having to do your search for geography again, you can just copy that link from the browser. So I'm just going to use it here. I can copy. I can add the year from 2018 to 2019, and you see the new data set. Let's go back to 2017 by changing the year 2018 to 2017. I'm just going to change age to 7, press enter, and you see that the new table now is for the year 2017. Another trick that you can do here is change the table to see a totally different table. Over the years working with census data, I start creating a list of my favorite tables that are available from the American Community Survey or census products. I want to make sure that every time I need to find a data table, I knew how to get to it right away and search by what we call table ID. How do you go about doing that? You can just change the table on the URL that you saved. In this case, we have the DP05. I can change from DP05 to DP03 for the economic profile. I could do the same to find the housing profile by changing from DP03 to DP04. And you can also go to DP02, which is the social characteristics profile. If you're looking for a table that's not a profile and you know the table ID, all you need to do is replace the product here, in this case the DP, as well as the table ID by the new table ID. So let me go to a table that I use often. It's B05006. I replace DP with the table ID as well as DP04 with B05006. I press enter and I'll see a table, place of birth for the foreign-born population for the same geography or geographies that you have selected. Let me show you another table. I'll look at language spoken at home by the ability to speak English. So I'll modify here where it says DT to B16001. And I'll also modify here to B16001. Press enter. And I have the language spoken at home by the ability to speak English table from the American Community Survey. You can also change the table from 1 year to 5 years by changing the 1 in front of the Y to 5 and see different data sets. Again, it's very useful to know how to work with a URL link and make different calls for data in the system. This is a very useful trick. For more videos like this, visit census.gov/academy and subscribe. Thank you.